Are you looking for a beautiful destination in Argentina to visit, perhaps after your Antarctica cruise? Look no further than Bariloche. Join me in this video as I take you on an adventure through the beautiful Lake District of Argentina, starting with the majestic Cerro Otto, followed by the pretty town of Bariloche. Coming up next. Buenos dias. Hi fellow travelers, this is Ken and welcome to my channel, Ken Travels 360. After the Antarctica cruise, we decided to come to the Lake District of Argentina to visit. So here we are in Bariloche, where we'll be spending 3 days here. Now, how did we get here though? Let's rewind back to this morning when we left our hotel in Buenos Aires and got onto a cab.
Good morning, so we are on the go again. This time we are going to the Jorge Newbery Airport.
So we just arrived at Jorge Newbery Airport. This is the domestic airport. It's very near the city center. So luggage has been checked in and we are now off the security area.
We got a priority boarding. Well, probably priority boarding onto the bus.
Right, we are on the runway. As the plane takes off, we get a fantastic bird's eye view of the city. Looking out the window, I can see the runway below, stretching out into the distance as the plane gains altitude. You can spot the area of Puerto Madero. That's where the high-rise buildings have been springing up in recent years. As the plane continues its ascent, I can also see the busy ports of Buenos Aires. In the La Boca area, you can spot the bustling port area where ships come and go. As we leave Buenos Aires behind, the landscape starts to change. First, we'll see the fertile pampas grasslands. Then, as the plane continues on its journey, we begin to see the landscape below becoming more rugged and mountainous. The Andes loom ever large in the distance. And one of them, I believe, is Osorno Volcano, which we went to 3 years ago when we went to the Chilean side of the Lake District. Okay, it's landing time. In Argentina, when the plane lands successfully, people will clap. I'll keep this rolling, wait for that moment.
Señoras y señores, bienvenidos a San Carlos de Bariloche. Les solicitamos permanecer sentados con el cinturón de seguridad abrochado hasta que se haya apagado el cartel.
So we arrive at Bariloche.
Yes.
The view driving from the airport to the city is amazing. Everywhere you see snowy mountains. It's really beautiful here. It's a bit like Switzerland actually.
Right, so we have arrived at Bariloche and we have arrived at the first attraction. It's a Teleférico Cerro Otto. Right, we are gonna take the cable car to go up to the mountain. Let's go. So I just show you the price of a cable car ride, but I think it's actually a bonus to show you with the price system here. By next month, this price will be irrelevant. Let's go. Ooh, here we go. Just got on the Teleférico Cerro Otto. Behind Steve, the view is absolutely magnificent. It's the lake. That's a Lago Nahuel Huapi. Yes, I've been practicing. So the cable car has just arrived at the upper station. Whoa, we just got turned.
Hola, ¿qué tal?
Gracias. Not quite sure how high it is here, but I feel a bit lightheaded as soon as I got up here. Apparently, the altitude here is 1,405 meters. So we just arrived by cable car to the top of Cerro Otto. Behind me is the city of Bariloche and the impressive lake Nahuel Huapi. So this is the Revolving Restaurant. Right now, we're at the Revolving Restaurant of Cerro Otto. So if you only see the view from the panoramic deck, you'll be quite disappointed because they have definitely reserved the best view in the Revolving Restaurant. You simply have to get some food and sit here to enjoy the view. The food here is really overpriced. Consider paying admission to a Revolving Restaurant. When you sit here, you'll be given a tag that recorded your time of arrival. You have an hour to enjoy the view once you're boarded. It involves around 15 minutes for one rotation, so you get to see the lake about four times. And so you can prepare yourself to take videos, photos, everything. It's well worth it. It's only about 15 minutes drive from Bariloche, and it's a nice introduction to the whole area. Tomorrow, we'll be driving the Circuito Chico, the small circuit, around the lake. From the outside, you can also see the lakes, but realistically, you can only see half of the lakes. So we have spent a great afternoon at Cerro Otto, and now it's time to descend back to Bariloche.
After visiting Cerro Otto, we drove back to the city center of Bariloche. Here, we are now at the Civic Centre of Bariloche, and it's opened in March 1940. It was designed by architect Ernesto de Estrada, and it was built with cypress wood and Tuva limestone. Later in the evening, we came back to see how it looked like when the lights were turned on, and the whole place looked so magical, particularly with all these beautiful log and stone buildings in the backdrop. This is the town hall of Bariloche. It's beautifully decorated for Christmas with nutcrackers in front. Here, we have the Museum of Patagonia. Surrounded by mountains, Bariloche is also the number one skiing resort in South America. Bariloche was settled by European immigrants from a dozen European countries, and the influence can be seen everywhere here. For example, they are the number one chocolate makers in Argentina because of the Swiss influence. No visit to Bariloche is complete without trying some of the world-famous chocolate, and there are plenty of chocolate shops around the city center. We decided to check this one out, called RapaNui, which is the Polynesian name for Easter Island. Rapasaurios, chocolate in the shape of dinosaur. Well, we have got a lot of souvenirs, chocolate, alfajores already, but it looks so beautiful. I think we're gonna have to pick up a couple of these chocolate truffles. It's very cheap. It's only 550 peso for a box. That is about £1.50-ish. So I'm not sure you can get something like this for that kind of price in England or anywhere else. So we got our chocolate. So it's worth walking around. We got some unexpected souvenirs. As I just mentioned, it's chocolates everywhere here. You can see behind me. So besides chocolate, they are also famous for making beer. No stuff thanks to another European tradition. This is the main cathedral of Bariloche. The cathedral is located close to the Nahuel Huapi Lake and is surrounded by beautiful gardens.
Wow, you see a Swiss restaurant here? That's a fondue. If you enjoyed watching this video, please give me a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to my channel with notifications enabled. That way, YouTube will notify you whenever I release a new video.
Right, it's now time to head to the lakefront to check out the stunning views of Lago Nahuel Huapi, one of the largest lakes in Patagonia. The best place to do that is from Mirador Lago Nahuel Huapi. Here, you will also find the iconic sign of Bariloche. Almost every tourist who comes here takes a photo of it with the backdrop of the lake.
So we're staying in this hotel, Hampton by Hilton. It might not look very pretty from the outside, but it has a great lake view.
So we just arrived at Hampton by Hilton, Bariloche. The check-in staff were really helpful. Now, we've been allocated a room 308, which is a lake view room. Let's go check out the room. Right, it's a twin bedroom. The design is quite pretty. It has got air conditioner. But the best thing, reason we come here is for the lake. And we got a lake view here.
So this is the view from the hotel room. It's definitely got a good lake view.
This is a shower. And you've got the toilet and the bidet.
Okay, it's now time to go have dinner.
So after half an hour, we finally managed to find a restaurant for dinner. We went to Alto El Fuego. It's the most popular restaurant in this city. And we waited and waited and was then told we had to wait for a whole hour before we may have a table. So we went somewhere else and we got to this place, La Paria, the Julian. And they only just opened and we managed to get a table. So that's great. We order a beer and they only come in 1 liter size.
Let me show you the enormous bottle.
So we order some salad and it just arrived. It's ginormous, this rocket salad. So we've ordered a lot of grilled stuff. There's a chorizo at the near front. Then the rest are lamb. We ordered quite a lot of lamb, wow. Bon appetit.
So we just have dinner at La Paria de Julian, but actually it's not very good.
Quite disappointed, the lamb was a bit chewy and it's not very tasty.
After the disappointing meal, we need to finish the evening on a better note. So we decided to go to this Heladeria called Jauja, which apparently serves the best helado in Bariloche.
Look at this helado. It has dulce de leche con nuez, as well as chocolate andino. So we just had a helado at Jauja. They have a lot of choices as you can see on the board behind, and they're really good.
After that scrumptious ice cream, we returned to our hotel just in time for the sunset. And with that, we conclude this video. I hope you enjoyed watching it. Next time, I will show you the most popular scenic driving excursion in Bariloche, the Circuito Chico. Until next time, ciao!